Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschachyate Shatarine Vanchakaupata Rupyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're studying the Brihad Bhagavat Amrita by Sanatan Goswami. And we are hearing about Maharaj Parikshit, who's preparing for leaving the world. He only has a short time to remain in this world before his death.
我们一直在学习的是《大伯伽瓦禅》这部书的作者是Srila Sanatana Goswami。我们聆听到Maharaj Parikshita准备离开这个世界，他在这个世界上待的时间不多了，他马上就要面临自己的死亡。So
his mother, Uttara, desired to hear the essence of what he had learned from the Srimad Bhagavatam.
自己的母亲乌特拉渴望聆听他自己的儿子从圣典伯伽瓦塔那里学到的精髓。So
Maharaj Parikshit was describing the glories of Vrindavan and the different people in Vrindavan.
Maharaj Parikshit 现在在荣耀温达文的荣耀温达文以及温达文的居民。
He began by glorifying the clouds, and then the rivers, and the trees, and the animals. And then he came to the cowherd. The cowherd boys, right? He's describing the cowherd boys.
Local women,
even that. Well, no, we're not at the women yet.
Parikshit Maharaj 又荣耀了Vrindavan的牧牛童.
Right. So this. Cowherd boys were all very special souls who had performed pious activities over many lifetimes when they had come to be with Lord Krishna in Vrindavan. So Sukadeva Goswami was describing to Maharaj Parikshit in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami was describing to Maharaj Parikshit about these cowherd boys, how some boys would sing songs which were suitable to the particular mood of Lord Krishna. And when some of these boys would sing the songs, Krishna would feel very pleased that it would be just the right mood for him. And the other cowherd boys, they would also increase their love for Krishna.
些男孩子们唱的这些动人的歌曲的时候呢，Krishna 就会感到心满意足，因为这正适合他的心态，而且这些歌曲也增加了其他牧牛童对 Krishna 的爱。
So for example, sometimes Krishna would, they would sing a song which was just, it would help him to take his nap, to have a rest, and feel sleepy. Hearing them sing the songs, he would feel sleepy and he could go to sleep quickly.
比如说，Krishna 在午休的时候，那些有的牧牛童朋友呢，都会唱一些就帮助他催眠的歌曲，以便他能够很快的入睡。
So Krishna is very grave, he's very deep, deeper than all the oceans. But he would be fascinated by the loving dealings which he had with the gopis. If they would sing about his dealings with the gopis, when Krishna would hear the cowherd boys sing songs about him with the gopis, then Krishna would be fascinated by these songs.
虽然 Krishna 就像人，就像大海一样深邃庄重，但是当他聆听到牧牛童朋友们歌颂他和牧牛姑娘之间的爱恋交往的时候呢，他也被深深吸引了。
So Krishna's mind was strongly attracted to these different kinds of songs which would glorify his devotional service.
Krishna, 每当听到这些荣耀对他的奉爱服务的歌曲的时候，他的心意就会被深深的吸引，感到心驰神往。
Sukadeva Goswami actually describes Krishna as a Mahatma, as a great soul. But sometimes we know that Krishna would do unusual things to these girls of Vrindavan.
虽然 Sukadeva Goswami 把 Krishna 描述为是 Mahatma, 伟大的灵魂，但是 Krishna 会对这些 Vrindavan 的牧牛姑娘们做一些非同寻常的非凡的事情。
But we know sometimes Krishna would, you know, he's like a womanizer, because he would indulge, he would show sometimes a lusty tendency, like he stole the clothes of the young cowherd girls of the gopis, and he would get them to become to stand naked before him. So that was a lusty, we could say almost like a lusty person to do something like that.
Krishna 就好像是一个花花公子，他好像是他会偷牧牛姑娘的衣服来展示他的这些色欲的倾向，他会让这些姑娘们赤身裸体的站立在他的面前，就几乎就好像 Krishna 是一个很色欲的男孩子。
But Krishna's friends, they would sing songs about Lord Krishna's pastimes, and when they would sing these songs, the other cowherd boys, their hearts would melt hearing the songs. Their hearts would become filled with love for Krishna.
当 Krishna 的牧牛童朋友歌颂他的消时光的时候，其他的聆听的男孩子们的内心就会在对 Krishna 的爱当中呢融化了。
Pure love for Krishna always comes in the hearts of in the course of devotional service. If people are doing devotional service, they will develop pure love for Krishna.
那些从事对 Krishna 奉爱服务的人们会发展起对 Krishna 的爱。
And the way it can develop The fastest way in which we can develop love for Krishna is when we do Sankirtan by singing songs which are dear to Krishna and which glorify Krishna's name and form.
对 Krishna 的爱的最快的途径捷径，就是从事 Sankirtan 提诵圣名，就歌颂那些对 Krishna 非常亲切的歌曲，歌颂 Krishna 的名字，歌颂 Krishna 的形体。
So all the boys who are there with Krishna in the forest, who are his friends there with, and the cowherd boys, they're all free from all sin. They were all great souls, and they were very advanced in devotional service.
在森林当中和 Krishna 一起玩耍的男孩子们，全都是摆脱了一切罪恶的。他们都是伟大的灵魂，他们在奉爱服务当中是非常精进的。
And they felt that as they did their service for Krishna, they felt more and more love for him.Their hearts were melting in ecstasy.
当他们从事为 Krishna 做服务的时候，他们内心对 Krishna 的爱是愈发增长了，然后他们内心就会在这个爱当中融化了。
So these boys, they were actually also Mahatmas, just like Krishna is a Mahatma. They were also Mahatmas.
就像 Krishna 本人是 Mahatma, 伟大的灵魂。那这些男孩子们也都像他一样，也是马哈马伟大的灵魂。
And Sukadeva Goswami, he addresses Maharaj Parikshit, he calls him Maharaj, a great king. He calls him like that because he's. This could mean that Krishna's being given service fit for a king.
So
Sukadeva Goswami was addressing Maharaj Parikshit as Maharaj.
Sukadeva Goswami 就称 Parikshit 为 Maharaj， Maharaj 的意思是伟大的国王。
Yeah. So this can mean different things.
所以它可能有不同的含义。
It can mean that Krishna is being served like a great king.
一个含义呢，就是。Krishna 被当作伟大的国王来服务。
Or it may mean that kings like Maharaj Parikshit cannot expect to get such luxury.
第二个含义是，像 Parikshit 大军这样的国王，不能期望，就如同 Krishna。
Or it could be Sukadeva Goswami's way of describing to Maharaj Parikshit the good fortune of the cowherd boys. And it could be Sukadeva Goswami's way of just.Showing his, he wants to attract the attention of Maharaj Parikshit. So he calls him Maharaj. He wants to attract his attention.
也意味着 Sukadeva Goswami 希望吸引 Parikshit 大军的注意力，所以他就称他为 Maharaj.
Because Maharaj Parikshit is going to be also influenced by Prem. He has also great love for Krishna. So Sukadeva Goswami wants to make sure he's paying attention, that he's not just only thinking of Krishna, but he's hearing the pastimes which Sukadeva Goswami is describing. And it can also indicate that Maharaj Parikshit is the only one who is able to actually understand the good fortune of these cowherd boys to be with Krishna. And it also shows the feeling, the attachment which these cowherd boys have for Krishna, that it's very wonderful, that they have a very deep attachment for Krishna. This is the Maharaja of loving sentiments. So this love, this kind of love is always present within these boys, within these cowherd boys. But it will increase more when they're in a very intimate setting. So it's totally pure, there's no contamination there at all. So Sukadeva Goswami is described about the cowherd boys. Next he's going to describe about Mother Yashoda and her love for Krishna. So he says Mother Yashoda's breast milk was sucked by Krishna, so she must have done many auspicious activities to have that good fortune, to have Krishna suck her breast milk. Okay, so Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, they were the parents of Lord Krishna. They were the ones to enjoy the childhood pastimes of Lord Krishna.
Nanda 大君和雅舍的妈妈是享受了 Krishna 孩提时代逍遥时光的他的父母。
So Krishna showed special mercy to Mother Yashoda. He showed the universal form, and he displayed other pastimes with Mother Yashoda, very special.
Krishna 向雅舍的展示了特殊的仁慈，他给他展示了他的宇宙形体，他还展示了他的其他的逍遥时光。
He made to the people of Vrindavan, the Brijbasis, he let them all know that he was the Supreme Lord.
He 不让 Brijbasis 自人们知道他自己作为至尊主的地位。
No, no, 他只让他们知道。
Sorry, 那 Krishna 让他们知道了他作为尊主的地位。
But he showed special mercy to his mother because he covered himself in that he didn't let her know that he was the Supreme Lord.
但是他没有让亚修的妈妈知道，他把他作为至尊主的身份隐藏了起来。
She can only think of Krishna as her son. Krishna covers her consciousness so that even though she sees all these things,She can only think of Krishna as her son. So Mother Yashoda can experience the most pure love for Krishna.
So Yashoda's mother can experience the most pure love for Krishna.
So Parikshit was asking a question that only Krishna himself can answer. Right, he wants to know what special pious activities did Nanda and Yashoda do in order to get this position to enjoy so much love for Krishna.
南德和亚修的到底做了哪些特殊的虔诚活动，所以他们才能够享受到对 Krishna 如此的爱呢？
Yeah, the devotional service of Nanda and Yashoda is the highest perfection, and no other devotees can equal it. Even Vasudev and Devaki, they could not equal the love of Nanda and Yashoda.
南德和亚修的同时的奉献服务是如此的完美，甚至连巴斯德和德拉基的服务都完美。
Although Krishna was so pleased with Vasudev and Devaki that he became their son, but.They could not enjoy Krishna's childhood pastimes.
虽然主 Krishna 对 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 非常满意，做了他们的儿子，但是他们却无法享受 Krishna 孩提时代的小时光。
Now Krishna's childhood pastimes are so powerful that anybody who chants about them and describes them, they get rid of all the contamination of the material world from their heart.
Krishna 孩提时代的消逝光是如此的强大有力，任何人唱诵描述他孩提时代消逝光的人们他们内心的物质污染也会扫而光。
And Vasudeva and Devaki, they were actually Krishna's real parents, but they were not so fortunate as Nanda and Yashoda because they did not get to see Krishna's childhood pastimes.
虽然 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 是 Krishna 的亲生父母，但是他们却不如 Nanda 和 Yashoda 那么幸运，得以目睹 Krishna 亲眼目睹 Krishna 孩提的消逝光。
Krishna gave the highest enjoyment to the world by performing his wonderful childhood pastimes.
Krishna 通过他孩提的上演了他美妙的孩提时代消失光，给世界带来了最高的享受。
It is said, even today in the Kali Yuga, great poets like Lord Brahma and Vyasadeva sing about Krishna's pastimes.
你说。甚至在如今的卡里年代，像主 Brahma 和 Vasudeva 这样伟大的诗人，也在歌唱 Krishna 的逍遥。
And by singing about Krishna's pastimes, they get rid of all the evil of the modern age.
吟唱 Krishna 的消海提的Krishna 的消时光，他们就能够摆脱这个当今年代的所有邪恶。
If we don't glorify Krishna's pastimes, then we'll never get rid of all the faults of Kali Yuga.
倘若不荣耀 Krishna 消失光，就永远无法改正、纠正哈利年代的错误。
So the pure devotees have always glorified Krishna and his pastimes, even to the present day.
纯粹的奉献者们，永恒的在荣耀 Krishna 的消失光。甚至是今日，他们仍在这样做。
So, when we do sankirtan, it removes the misery of all the living entities. Sankirtan is so powerful; it destroys all the miseries for all living entities.
其颂圣名 sankirtan， 它是如此的强大有力。它可以去除所有生物体的痛苦。
By engaging in this hearing and chanting of Krishna's pastimes, we can develop the highest love for Krishna.
通过从事于聆听、唱诵 Krishna 的消时光，就能发展起对 Krishna 最崇高的爱。
And the effect of the Krishna's pastimes is it will disturb our peace of mind.
Krishna 的逍遥时光的效力就是它会让我们平和的心意受到打扰。
And sometimes the effect of hearing about Krishna's pastimes is that we're not able to speak.
有的时候聆听 Krishna 消失光导致的结果就是我们一下子说不出话来了。
And another effect of Sankirtan is it changes the attitude of everybody who takes part.
Sankirtan 颂圣名另外一个奇妙的效果就是它会影响任何参与其中圣名的人的内心。
The effect is that we no longer think about impersonalism or about our own self. We start to think of Krishna.
它的奇妙的效果就是，我们不会在有内心有非人格主义的倾向，而且会。也忘记了自己。那么我们只想 Krishna。
Srimad Bhagavatam describes some of Krishna's wonderful pastimes which he performed when he was with Nanda and Yashoda.
正典薄伽瓦坛描述了当 Krishna 和 Nanda 和 Yashoda 在一起的时候的奇妙的逍遥。
If it wasn't for these wonderful pastimes, this mercy of Krishna,then Mother Yashoda would just be on the same level as Devaki.
如果没有这些奇妙的逍遥，雅舍的妈妈的地位，她得到仁慈，就跟Devaki 会是一样的。
And Devaki also gave her breast milk to Krishna.
Devaki 也给 Krishna 哺乳。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it describes howKrishna's older brothers were brought back from death, and at that time,
in 圣典薄伽瓦坛当中描述说 ，Krishna 的哥哥在那个时候也被带了回来。
And they also drank Devaki's milk, breast milk, and but that time they drank it was the remnants of Lord Krishna.
那些康瑟杀死的 Krishna 的哥哥们也被带了回来之后呢，就吮吸了 Devaki 妈妈的母乳，这些母乳是 Krishna 喝剩下的。
So these six elder brothers of Krishna, they all touched the body, they touched the body of the Lord, and just by contacting his body, they got freed of any kinds of contamination.
Krishna, 那六位哥哥，他们触碰了主的身体。
So that tells us that Devaki had also given her breast milk to Krishna. When Krishna appeared at his birth, he was in a four-armed form. So Devaki begged him to become an ordinary baby. And so Krishna changed his form to become like a little baby. So at that time, Krishna, when he became a baby, he must have been on the lap of Devaki for a minute or two. And at that time, he must have also drank the milk from Devaki's breast. And then also when Brahma stole away Krishna's calves, and all Krishna's cowherd boyfriends, Krishna took their place. And so Krishna, in the form of the cowherd boys, he was drinking the milk of all the different cowherd women.
Krishna, when he became the cowherd boys, 他也忍尽了所有温达文牧牛女的乳汁。
And Krishna, in the form of a calf, he was drinking the milk from all the cows, the mother cows.
Krishna 作为小牛犊, 他也忍尽了温达文所有牛的牛奶。
So Parikshit Maharaj takes care to distinguish Yashoda's personal fortune. What is special about Mother Yashoda?
So Parikshit Maharaj, 他就尤其小心翼翼地区分了雅修达她的巨大的好运。
Because so many of these other ladies, they also gave their breast milk to Krishna.
因为有那么多的女士们都给Krishna喂奶了。
So Parikshit, he uses the word Hari to call Lord Krishna, because it shows that by the motherly love, by the love of Mother Yashoda, Krishna performs his childhood leela. Parikshit
Maharaj 呼唤Krishna为Hari，表明了由于Yashoda妈妈的母爱，所以Krishna 还上演了所有那些美妙的逍遥。
And by his pastimes, then Mother Yashoda's mind is always absorbed in thinking of Krishna.
就是由于这些种类非凡的逍遥时光，所以Krishna吸引了雅修达妈妈的心。
And Mother Yashoda is described as even more fortunate than Nanda Maharaj, because she's the mother, and so the mother will have more affection than the father for the child. And the child will have more affection to the mother than to the father. And we see Lord Krishna also like that, that he has more love for Mother Yashoda. Just like Mother Yashoda tied him up with ropes.
Krishna
And this will be described in a few verses we'll hear, how Mother Yashoda ties up Krishna.
在以下的几个时节，我们将聆听到亚洲的妈妈是如何把 Krishna 绑了起来。So
Vasudeva and Devaki, they'd worship Krishna with devotion for four yugas to get him as their son.
Vasudeva 和 Devaki 崇拜了 Krishna 四个年代之久，来得到 Krishna 成为自己的儿子。
But they did not get the blessings equal to what Nanda and Yashoda got. Vasudeva and Devaki could not enjoy Krishna's pastimes where he's crawling about and is acting like a little child. And this is what Lord Brahma and many great people write songs and poems about, describing Krishna as a child crawling around.
Brahma 还有其他伟大的诗人们
So when Krishna became the son of Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, they both attained perfect. They were both perfectly fixed in their love for Krishna. And so did all the gopis and the gopas in Vrindavan. They were all blessed because they're able to also see the childhood pastimes of Lord Krishna.
所有文达文的高卡、高比、牧牛郎、牧牛女都被祝福，能够亲眼目睹 Krishna 作为孩子的小孩子的逍遥。
So in a previous birth, Nanda and Yashoda were blessed by Lord Brahma to get the highest devotion for Krishna.
在他们的前一生，Nanda和Yashoda 被主 Brahma 祝福，可以获得对主 Krishna 的爱。Brahma
is a first-class devotee, and by his benediction, Nanda and Yashoda, they develop perfect love for Krishna.
Brahma 是一流的奉献者。
So Krishna is also called Janardhan. He's known as Janardhan because everyone wants to be. Everyone wants to get from Krishna. What they think is important in life, and you know their material desire, their different desires can be fulfilled. So everyone worships Krishna to get. They want to satisfy their desires.
Krishna 也被称为Janardhan，因为人人都想崇拜 Krishna 来满足他们个人的内心的愿望。But
Nanda and Yashoda, they just consider Krishna important. They don't think about anything else. They're just thinking that Krishna is important, and they want to have him as their son. to be with them, to be with them.
Nanda 也说的，只把 Krishna 当作最重要的，是最重要的人。他们只想让 Krishna 做自己的儿子，他们只想跟他们在一起。
So of course Krishna is, he is the Supreme Lord. He cannot be born the son of anyone. But because he understood their mood of devotion, he reciprocates with them.
Krishna is the 尊主，他不可能出生为任何人的儿子，但是他明白别人内心的父爱，所以便回报他们。
So to allow them to develop that mood of devotion, Krishna becomes the son of his devotees.
为了允许其他人发展他们的父爱，所以他就成为了他奉献者的儿子。
He becomes the son of Nanda and Yashoda, and he shows his wonderful qualities, especially his concern for his devotees.
他便成为 Nanda Yashoda 的儿子，展示了他奇妙的品质，展示了他关怀奉献者。
So because Brahma gave the benediction, so the devotion of Nanda and Yashoda was very fixed on Krishna.
因为 Brahma 给予了祝福， Nanda 和 Yashoda 便他们对 Krishna 的奉爱便是稳若磐石的。
And all the people in Vrindavan, all the gopas and the gopis, they all have love for Krishna. They're all pure devotees. But the love shown by Nanda and Yashoda is the greatest, greater than everyone else.
Vrindavan 的所有的人，所有的 gopa、gopi、牧牛郎、牧牛姑娘，全部是纯粹的奉献者。但是Nanda 和 Yashoda 所展示的爱是最伟大，超过了其他的人。
This means especially when Krishna is a child, when he's a young child, they have the greatest love. But when Krishna starts to grow up, you know, he comes to like this stage of Poganda, where he's 10 years old, then the mood changes a bit.
特别是当 Krishna 是小孩子的时候，他们展示出最伟大的爱。当 Krishna 长大，他达到 Poganda age 年龄，就十岁的时候，他们的心态有所改变。
And when it comes to the older stage of Kishore, that's maybe like about maybe older, maybe 12 or 15, then the mood is different. Then he has Krishna's.Developing his relationship with the gopis.
When Krishna 达到超过十岁，达到十二岁、十五岁这样的时候，他的心态就发展了。他发展出了对 gopi 和牧牛姑娘的和他们发展出关系。
Of course, even when Krishna is a child, Krishna is also showing great affection for the gopis.
当然 ，Krishna 还是小孩子的时候，他也对 gopi 牧牛姑娘们怀着爱。
So then, we hear about.The time when Uddhava came to visit to Vrindavan.
We
So Sukadeva Goswami is talking to Maharaj Parikshit, and he knows Maharaj Parikshit is, he's coming, he's a descendant of the great king Bharat Maharaj.
Sukadeva Goswami, he is talking to Parikshit Dajin. He knows Parikshit Dajin is Bharat Maharaj's descendant.
So he's telling him that Maharaj Parikshit should now be able to answer his own question about how Nanda and Yashoda got so much love for Krishna and how Krishna became their son.
Also, Maharaj Parikshit Maharaj, he can't answer his own question.
为什么难得亚修的对昆士那怀着如此深厚的爱，对昆士那，他应该自己回答他的问题。他应该，马哈拉，苏格德戈斯瓦米告诉他，他应该回答自己的问题，为什么？哦，OK，苏格德戈斯瓦米告诉难得。 Yeah, in a previous life, Devaki and Vasudeva worshipped Krishna. Their desire was just to get a son like him. So Krishna gave them the blessing that he would become their son. In three births.
Krishna 便祝福他们，会作为他们的儿子，成为三世，成为他们的儿子。
Now Nanda and Yashoda, they prayed that they would get pure devotional service to Krishna.
而Nanda和Yashoda的祈祷是能够为 Krishna 从事纯粹的父爱服务。
And Lord Brahma agreed, he gave them the blessing that they would get this. So Krishna shows that when you get the blessing of a devotee, it's more valuable than getting the blessing directly from Krishna. So Krishna came down to earth, he came down to this planet to perform his pastimes, his childhood pastimes, for the benefit of his parents, like Nanda and Yashoda. And for the benefit of everyone who is related to Nanda and Yashoda also. So the Krishna's childhood pastimes, they're so much greater than any other goal of life, which we know in the material world. And Nanda Maharaj and the other Brijbasis, they're all Krishna's eternal associates, and they're his very dear devotees. So it only appears that Brahma's blessing them, but actually they're Krishna's eternal devotees. So Parikshit Maharaj should he should be aware, he should understand this.
So he Parikshit
So Sukadeva Goswami says to Maharaj Parikshit, he says, Nanda Maharaj was very liberal and very simple. He's a simple cowherd man, you know. He's very simple and he's very kind-hearted. So one time he was coming home after he'd gone on a trip, he'd gone to Mathura on some business, and so when he was coming back, then he took his son Krishna on his lap and he was smelling Krishna's head, so he enjoyed transcendental bliss.
有一次南达玛拉吉呢就从马苏拉办事回家之后呢他就把奎奇呢抱到自己的腿上开始闻嗅奎奇呢的头享受着他们的极乐。So
Vasudev, he was also, you could also say he was Krishna's father, but Nanda has an even greater right to consider Krishna his son.
虽然呢, Vasudeva呢, 是 Krishna的一生父亲, 但是南达达君呢, 更有权利来把 Krishna认为是自己的儿子。
So we see one pastime, Nanda Maharaj had gone to Mathura because he had to pay taxes to King Kamsa. And so when he was coming back, he saw that Krishna had killed the demon Putana.
So, 在一个消食纲当中呢，说南达大君呢有一次去马图拉给康萨国王上税，等他回来之后呢，他看到Krishna杀死了女巫Putana。So
when Nanda saw the demon Putana dead, and he saw that Krishna was still alive, then Nanda Maharaj was very happy.
Nanda Maharaj 看到女巫Putana已经倒地死去了，而他的儿子 Krishna 还活着，他变得非常的快活。
Of course, all the Brijbasi people, they were shocked to see Putana. She was a huge Rakshasi. She was many miles long, and she was killed by Krishna. So the Brijbasi people were thinking, wow, this baby Krishna is very powerful, that he could kill such a big Rakshasi. But Nanda Maharaj, he didn't think like that. Nanda Maharaj was just thinking, Krishna's my son.
Nanda Maharaj 没有这种想法，他只是把 Krishna 当成他的小儿子。
So his love for Krishna increased. He didn't think, oh, Krishna, my son must be God. He just had more love and he was concerned for the welfare of his child.
对他对 Krishna 的爱反而增长了。他并没有想我的儿子是神，他只是爱 Krishna。
So Nanda Maharaj came home and he took Krishna, he picked him up and he put him on his lap and he embraced him and he was in ecstasy and Nanda was smelling his head and, you know, smelling the hair on Krishna's head and he felt so much pleasure to have Krishna as his son.
把Krishna抱在怀里，放在自己的膝头上，然后使劲的闻着他的头，然后闻着抚摸着，闻着他的柔软的。Serving
her Lord Narayan, Hari Bol, can you hear me? Hari Krishna. Gurumani? Hare Krishna? Hare Krishna, Guru Mani. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Ma.
What we like?
I lost you.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So I was saying, Nanda. Guru Mani, Nizai Ma?
What's that?
Okay.
Hare Krishna, what's that?
Okay. No. Haribo.
Haribo.
Good morning.
Yes, I'm here.
Okay. Okay, so I was saying Nanda Maharaj experienced more happiness than the Goddess of Fortune experienced.
Nanda Maharaj.
The Goddess of Fortune, of course, she is able to serve the lotus feet and to be on the chest of Lord Narayan, but Nanda Maharaj feels more happiness than she does. Nanda Maharaj shows what a great devotee he is. When they had the name-giving ceremony of Krishna, he gave away a lot of charity.
Nanda Maharaj 他是多么伟大的一个奉献者，当在主 Krishna 的命名仪式上, 给 Krishna 取名的仪式上, 他做了大量的布施。
And he's also very intelligent, because he didn't want any other benediction from Brahma. Only the boon of exclusive devotion for Krishna. So, why are we only speaking about Nanda Maharaj? What about Mother Yashoda? Didn't she also get devotion for Krishna like him? Nanda, Mother Yashoda also got blessing from Brahma to get devotion for Krishna. Yeah, in the previous life, Nanda and Yashoda, they were called Drona and Dara, and they got blessings from Brahma. And they prayed that, please bless us, that we can take birth on the planet Earth. And we can, after the Supreme Lord appears, that we will also appear, that we will appear there and we will be able to spread devotional service, the goal of life.
他们祈求，向 Brahma 祈祷说，让我们在地球上投生。尊主显现在地球的时候，我们也同时显现在那里，能够传播、关爱、服务是生命的目标。
And people born in the material world can be delivered from the miserable condition of materialistic life.
物质世界的人们，他们都可以从物质痛苦当中摆脱出来。
So in the previous life, Nanda and Yashoda together, they both offered the same prayer. So shouldn't they both have the same ecstasy?
所以在前一世呢，南德、亚修的他们都献上了同样的祈祷。那么南德他们不应该怀有同样多的狂喜吗？
But we're hearing about Nanda Maharaj, how he's ecstatic after the killing of Putana.
但是我们刚才听到的是，在 Putana 女巫被杀死之后呢，南德玛拉的狂喜。
But wasn't Mother Yashoda ecstatic then?
那个时候难道亚修的妈妈也不难道不狂喜吗？
And the mother loves the child more than the father, so shouldn't her love have been even greater than Nanda Maharaj?
母亲对孩子的爱是超过了父亲，那么他当时的狂喜难道不会超过 Nanda Maharaj 吗？
Actually, it's true. Yashoda's love for Krishna is greater than Nanda Maharaj.
事实上也的确如此。Yashoda 对 Krishna 爱超过了 Nanda Maharaj 对 Krishna 爱。
But this is a special circumstance because Nanda Maharaj had just returned home.
但是这
So he'd come home after a long journey, and so naturally he was feeling special love for his child. He feels very happy to be reunited with his son.But Mother Yashoda, she was always there in the home. She had not been away from home.
So, Nanda Maharaj is, when Krishna 分别了很长一段时间之后，回到家又跟儿子重逢，而亚修的妈妈是日夜朝夕跟儿子相处。
So Mother Yashoda didn't feel the same ecstasy as Nanda Maharaj at that time.
所以在那个时候呢，亚修的妈妈感受到的狂喜。
Actually, both these pure devotees, their love for Krishna is always great. It can never go less or more. It's always fully developed.
事实上，这两位纯粹奉献者对 Krishna 总是怀着伟大的爱。他们的爱从来不会减少，他们的爱总是充满完美的。
Yeah, Nanda Maharaj has love for Krishna, it doesn't change. It doesn't become something, it doesn't become more, it doesn't become less. It's constant.
Nanda 对 Krishna 的爱是亘古不变的，它不会更多，也不会更少。
But in imitating sometimes family relationships, it appears to have changed due to family relationships.
但是有的时候，由于这种家庭关系。它表面上好像是有所改变。
But we see also that because he has pure love it's always rising. Different varieties of different emotions are going to be understood or experienced by these devotees.
但是由于他们的纯粹的爱，内心生成了这种纯粹的爱，所以他会有，他的魅力也会是各式各样的，这种情感，他们体验的情感也是多种多样的。
So the happiness which you get from prema is different from the happiness of liberation.
因此，从 prema 爱当中得到的快乐。
So Nanda Maharaj is, for a little while, he has this increase of love, was a special ecstasy because of this situation that he'd just come back after being away from home. Okay, we'll stop here today.
Krishna Kumar, we don't have any questions, right? Krishna Kumar Madhaji, can you help me?
Oh,
I'm on. You can read it, because I'm on the
keyboard. Okay. Sorry. Hari Vamsa, he told me, Radharani married to Danfush, it should be 18 years old. So if they married, it's probably not for the pleasure of enjoying. So I want to ask, if they married in the young age, and if a young girl has a very good skill, is this also the traditional tradition?
Thank Krishna, when Radharani got married with her husband, it must be before she was 8 years old. So definitely they got married not for sense gratification, My question is that when people get married when they are very young,
they are very young. So, 他们不是为了感官，Krishna，他的问题是什么？问题是，如果结婚不是为了感官享乐，那么请问少年时期结婚和少女时候就有好的厨艺，是不是这是伟大传统？好的什么厨艺？厨房艺术。
他问这两个少年时期结婚和有厨艺是不是伟大传统？少女时期和少年时期的这个。两个方面，一个是小的时候就结婚，还有一个是女孩子要就是做饭特别。
小的时候就有厨艺。
小时候，OK。让Radharani married when she was only 8 years old。 So at that time, there will be no sanctification. So is it a Vedic tradition that people got married when they are very young, and when girls should have a very good talent in the cooking? So is that the Vedic culture?
Yes, certainly. It was expected that the ladies would all be expert to cook and prepare food.
是的，所以就是人们就指望着就是新娘子呢，她应该特别擅长厨艺。
When they're very young, the girl is married, and then she doesn't have to worry about who is her husband. She's, you know, as a young child, she understands this man is my husband, and she's taught to serve that man.
他们小时候就结婚，同婚，就这样的女孩子呢，他们就不用为他们未来的夫君这件事儿发愁了，担心就是我长大以后嫁给谁，这样呢，他们就能安心心的、踏踏实实的可以伺候。
As she's growing up, she's always reminded, you know, that you serve your husband, take care of your husband, and so she will bring his meals, and she will also help to prepare the food to serve to her husband.
那么，随着这个小，年轻的小女孩子，她长大成年之后呢？他就总是受到周围的人的身边的人提醒，你应该去服侍你的丈夫，你应该去给你的丈夫做好吃的、可口的食物。
And they have to wash clothes and do different, clean the house, do these different things.
新娘子呢？新娘子她还应该是给丈夫就是洗衣服，还要打理这个家庭，清洁家庭。
She will learn what kind of food to prepare for the husband, what the husband likes, and how he likes it, and what time he eats, and so her duty will be there to serve the husband.
这是小女孩，新婚的小女孩要学会，她的丈夫，她喜欢什么口味，她应该什么时候吃饭，她作为这个新娘子，她的职责是什么？
So in this way, the young girl is, she's not looking at other men. She's absorbed, one man.
这种方式呢，这个年轻的姑娘呢，她就会一心一意地专注在她的丈夫身上，她就不会去，再琢磨其他的男子了。
So, in the modern culture, just like in the Western countries, sometimes you get young girls, they're already pregnant, you know, and they're not married.
新年代呢，女子有的结婚的时候是顶着大肚子结婚的。
So, it creates a very inauspicious, that's a very inauspicious situation. But where the girl is properly married and she knows who her husband is, then it's peaceful, natural.
所以如果就是未婚先先孕，这种是很不吉祥的一种情况。另外一方面呢，如果女孩子是明媒正娶，就是有恰当的婚姻的话，她就内心就很安定，因为她知道她的丈夫是谁，她就很平和。下一个，讲到了，真哈瑞克什纳，亲爱的 Maharaj， 顶拜您甜美莲花族，顶拜所有奉献者。两个人或三个人一起集诵圣名，是不是也叫散结坛？集诵圣名是不是人越多越能增加奉爱之情呢？真 asked， Hare Krishna, dear Maharaj, thank you for your sweet lotus feet and send advice to all devotees. And so the question is that when there are only two or three devotees, they held sankirtan. Is this also called sankirtan?
Yes.
是的。
Sankirtan can be even one person.
甚至一个人的时候也可以被称为是 sankirtan。
Lord Chaitanya sometimes will go and he will just go on his own. He will just sing and dance and chant.
Lord Chaitanya, 他有的时候他是有时候是一个人他在那里唱歌跳舞。
When he was in Benares, it's a Mayavadi place, so many Buddhas and Mayavadi sannyasis. Lord Chaitanya went there. He would go on his own. He would just go and sing and dance in the streets. So, Sankirtan can be even one person, but Sankirtan means, the word San means actually coming together, usually, so usually should be more people, but even one person, if there's nobody else, you can also do Sankirtan, because glorification of the Lord.
Sankirtan 的这个词呢，它本来的这个词源的意思就是说大家聚在一起来听，但是如果没有别人的话，一个人也可以 Sankirtan 荣耀主。
And Srila Prabhupada also taught us that book distribution is also Sankirtan.
Srila Prabhupada 教导我们说，看书也是 Sankirtan 集中寿命。
And here every day we're using the internet to do Sankirtan. Yeah. So Sankirtan means the glorification of the Lord. It can be on a very small scale, it can be on a big scale, it can be all over the globe.
所以 Sankirtan 的意思就是荣耀尊主，它既可以是小规模的，也可以是大范围的，甚至是全球范围内的。
嗯
哼。嗯，下一个问题是 Ina Hare Krishna Maharaj, devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. O glorious Srila Prabhupada.Vasudeva and Devaki performed harsh austerity to make Lord Krishna their son, but they never got the nectar of his childhood games. What are they missing to get it?
What are they what?
Missing. What are they missing? M-I-S-S-I-N-G.
They're missing just Krishna's childhood pastimes.
问题是，就是拉斯蒂巴和德拉基他们苦行来得到主库什纳为儿子，但是他们没有得到库什纳还有十个代的这个干部，那么他们缺失的是什么呢？回答是他们缺失了库什纳的孩童的消失光。
Just like a mother, you know, a woman, she may give birth to a child, and so as soon as she gives birth to the child.If the child is taken away from her, it is not very satisfying because there's so much pleasure the mother gets in seeing the child grow up, in seeing the child crawl, and in seeing the child, you know, drink her breast milk every day. It's very pleasing to the mother.
比如说吧，一个母亲她生了个孩子，可是那孩子一生下来就被抱走了，那对于这个母亲来说呢，就不是一个非常令人满意的情况，因为她失去了就是看着孩子长大成人的快乐，看着小孩子在地上爬，在看着孩子吮吸自己的乳汁这种快乐。
Yeah, a woman will take pleasure in watching her little child grow up, beginning to crawl, beginning to speak.
那么母亲呢，她会从孩子看着孩子在地上爬来爬去，听着孩子牙牙学语，从中得到巨大的快乐。
So why didn't Vasudeva and Devaki, why were they not allowed this pleasure?
那么问题就是，为什么 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 没有被允许来获得这种快乐呢？
Well, when they prayed, they'd only prayed for the Lord to come as their son. So he came as their son, he took birth, and then he left them.
因为当时他们祈祷的他们的祈祷就是 Krishna 能成为他们的儿子。可是呢，当主 Krishna 一生下来之后就离开了他们，离开自己的父母。
And he went to the home of Nanda and Yashoda.
然后 Krishna 就去了 Nanda 和 Yashoda 的家里。
Because Nanda and Yashoda, they had not just prayed simply to have Krishna as their son. They had prayed.To have the greatest devotion for Krishna.
因为南达和亚修的祈祷，并不是祈祷 Krishna 成为自己的儿子，他们的祈祷是拥有对 Krishna 的最伟大的了不起的父爱情。
Shruti Rupa Devdasi.
顶拜咕噜老师们，中秋快乐，中秋快乐，请教咕噜，我该如何正确理解中秋节对我的意义呢？我的爸爸出生于中秋节，去世21年了。父亲的大哥，我的大伯，去年中秋节去世，在生命最后一个小时接受了圣名额不加饭歌，还有我向他展示的咕噜您的照片，请咕噜训斥我，念应该作为什么提升父辈的灵魂感恩？Obeisance to Guru and teachers. Happy Moon Festival. My question is that how should see correctly the meaning of Moon Festival to me? Because 21 years ago, my father left the world, and my father's elder brother also passed away last year during the Moon Festival, and.He had accepted the holy name and Bhagavad Gita I told him, and also the picture, I showed your picture to him. So please instruct me, so on this special day, what should I do to elevate their souls? Thank you.
Yes, today also, so today is the auspicious day.Of Mid-Autumn Festival. So we wish everyone Chunjie Kwaila, Jongchio Jie Kwaila. And we have, to what can you do to elevate the souls of your father and your father's brother? Well, what you can do is to chant the holy name of Krishna for their honor, for their benefit. And you can also distribute the holy name and distribute Krishna's prasadam.For their pleasure, for their benefit.
那今天的中国的传统的中秋佳节，格鲁玛尔他也祝福所有的人中秋节快乐。那么对舒提朱克贝达西，他问他今天他应该做什么？那么他可以放送主克什那的圣名，并且派发圣名，派发克什那普沙的。是为了他的父辈的好处，为了他们的快乐来做这个派发圣名、派发那份沙的。
Just chanting the holy name and distributing the food offered to the Lord will always create an auspicious atmosphere for you and your family members and your departed family members also.
那么就是唱诵证明和派发祭鱼，就是在这个就过节的期间呢，永远就对于自己、对于 对于家人还有对于逝去的亲人们都会创造一个吉祥的氛围。Next one。下一个是哈瑞邦萨的问题。8岁和10岁前昆池的发展父母与儿子的感情，12岁到15岁间昆池的发展与木牛姑娘的感情。听说昆池的8岁就离开文达文了，怎么理解12岁到15岁的消失光？ During the period of 8 to 10 years old,Krishna has developed feelings, affection with his mother and father. And during the period of 12 to 15 years old, Krishna developed his feeling affection with Gopi. But I heard that Krishna left Vrindavan when Krishna was 8 years old. How can I understand the Leela between 12 to 15 years old of Krishna?
Yeah, well, when Krishna's a child, his pastimes are with Nanda and Yashoda. And when he's a young boy, his pastimes are with the cowherd boys. And as he gets older, he comes to adolescence, then his pastimes are more with the gopis.
Vrindavan Krishna
is
a child,他的关系是和南德和亚瑟的之间的关系。当昆士呢，稍微大一点，他长成了小男孩子的时候呢，他的关系是和那些牧牛童之间的关系。当他昆士呢再长大成青年的时候呢，他就跟他的关系是跟那些牧牛姑娘勾起的关系。
So I never heard anywhere that Krishna left Vrindavan when he was 8 years old.
我没有在哪里听说昆士呢8岁就离开了文达文。
No, never heard this.
从来没听说。Next one.
Yeah.
唐继东，顶拜姑，我替我儿子问俩问题。他问昆士呢为什么也有情感？不是神吗？神不是脱离人的躯体超然物外，不该没有情感吗？庞基东妈的 asked that on behalf of her son, she asked two questions. Why Krishna also have feeling, sentiment? Isn't Krishna God? And isn't God is beyond material things?Without any sentiment?
Yeah, you have to understand that because we have sentiments, everything which is we have, it actually comes from God Himself. So He has pure sentiments. Our sentiments are not pure.
我们是有情感的。我们的情感是来源于神的，但神是拥有的是纯粹的情感，我们的情感是不纯洁的。
Yes, everything which is here, all the different qualities which we see in this world, they have their origin coming from Krishna. But everything which comes from Krishna is pure. But when it comes into this material world and onto us,then it becomes perverted, contaminated.
在这里的一切品质，它们的源头是 Krishna， 但是在 Krishna 那里呢，这些品质都是纯洁的。但当这些品质在这个物质世界的时候，就是在我们身上的时候呢，这些品质是扭曲了的，是被污染了的。
Lord Krishna has feelings for his devotees. Just like the devotees have feeling for him, for Krishna, Krishna reciprocates the feelings for his devotees.
Krishna Krishna 对他的奉献者是怀着情感的，因为他的奉献者对 Krishna 怀着情感，所以为了回报奉献者， Krishna 也对奉献者们怀着情感。
We have lust when we want to we desire to exploit people and take advantage of them for our own satisfaction. Krishna is not like that.
我们拥有的是色欲，我们想要剥削别人，利用别人来满足我们的感官，满足我们自己。Krishna 不是这样。
Krishna loves his devotees. He will care for them. He will protect them. He's not trying to take advantage of them. He's not going to exploit them.
Krishna 是爱他的奉献者，关心他的奉献者，他不会利用他的奉献者，剥削奉献者。
You have to understand.Lord Krishna deals very fairly, very kindly with his devotees.
您要理解 ，Krishna 和他奉献者之间的交往，他是非常公平的对待奉献者，他是非常好心、善意、仁慈的对待奉献者。
If you think God has no feelings, then you make him impersonal. He's not a person anymore. But God is a person. He's the supreme person.
如果你认为神没有情感的话，那你就把他非人格化了，你就认为他并不是一个人。但 Krishna 神他是一个人，他是至尊的人。
Hey, he's not a person like we are. We are conditioned souls, and we are full of so many bad qualities. But Krishna is the original person, and he's perfect.
不是像我们这样的人，他不是受条件限制的，他也没有坏的品质，他是原初人，他是完美的人。
Okay, that would.
下一个是。
Yeah.
The next one.
Yeah.
Chaitanya Charan, Hare Krishna Dimai Gurudev, Karma Yoga 是不是？Is that karma yoga is not pure bhakti yoga?
No, karma yoga is not pure bhakti yoga. Karma yoga is mixed devotion.
活动瑜伽不是纯粹的奉爱瑜伽，活动瑜伽是混合的奉爱，混杂的奉爱。
Because there must be some karma yoga. We say we're attached to working. We're attached to doing a particular type of work.
活动瑜伽是对工作还依附工作。一副特定类型的工作。What's the distinction, and relationship between karma yoga and bhakti yoga?
Well, karma yoga is to perform our duty in a detached manner.
活动瑜伽就是以不依附的方式来履行我们的职责。
But bhakti yoga is to do whatever Krishna wants us to do.
而bhakti yoga 奉爱瑜伽是 Krishna 叫我们做什么，我们就做什么。
In karma yoga, we work, and then we may surrender the results of our work to Krishna.
活动瑜伽当中，我们可能我们是履行我们活动，然后我们把活动结果臣服给 Krishna。
But in bhakti yoga, first we surrender, And then we give everything to Krishna.
在富玛里家当中，我们首先我们臣服了，然后我们把一切都献给 Krishna.
And we'll do whatever Krishna wants us to do.
我们去做，无论 Krishna 要求我们做什么，我们做什么。
In Karma Yoga, when we give charity, we think, I'm giving this for Krishna. But the Bhakti Yogi, he knows everything belongs to Krishna. I'm giving Krishna what I'm giving, it's Krishna's, it's all Krishna's, it's not mine.
在活动里当中，当人已经布施的时候呢，他的心里的想法是，我把这个给 Krishna 了。但是在奉爱里家当中呢，人会认为一切是属于 Krishna 的，本来这些都是 Krishna 的，本来这也不属于我。
Okay.
The next one 是书籍，顶拜 Guru， 自己不会做饭，找个会做饭的伴侣是不是就可以了呢？年龄大了，再结婚，公婆想要孩子，如果伴侣不同意，同意不要孩子的话，是不是可以没有小孩子？占星师算过我命中注定有孩子，这一夜报能逃脱吗 ？So this devotee is paying obeisance to you, and this devotee said that if I'm not the expert in cooking, can I find a partner?Who is an expert in cooking?
Yes, you can find one. You should find one. If you don't cook yourself, then you should find somebody who does cook to cook for you.
是的，您应该找一个这样的。如果您自己不做饭的话，您应该找一个为您做饭的伴侣。And if I'm old, And I get married, but my father-in-law and mother-in-law, they want us to have children. But if my partner do not agree to get children, is it okay for us to not have children? Because the astrology said that in my destiny, there is a child.So can I escape this karma?
Yeah, karma is not 100%. Astrology is not 100%. Astrology may say some things that may not be exact.
是的，业报是可以改变的，占星师他们的说法也不是百分之百准确的。The astrology, what the saying of astrology is not 100% correct, right?
Yes.
所以就占星师也不是百分之百正确的。The next one?
Yeah.
Krishna Nam Das Dandavan Maharaj, 我想接着 Hari Vansa Prabhu 问题发问。既然伟达传统那么好，帮助人控制感官，提升度，那么 ISKCON为何不推荐奉献者和世人恢复早婚的模式呢？让12岁到16岁左右的孩子就结婚，能够解决许多物质问题，这样好。Krishna Nam Prabhu said, Dhanavad Maharaj, continue with the question of Harvans Prabhu. Since the Vedic culture is so nice, it can help people to control their senses and elevate themselves. Why?Don't ISKCON promote to devotees and people in general to restore the tradition of getting married very early so that the children can get married between 12 to 16 years old so that many mature problems can be solved. Is it very nice?
Yes, if it's, you know, if You have to consider what's the situation in each country. Some countries, they may not allow young children to be married. They may not understand the Vedic culture. They may not appreciate that although they're married, they may not be living together. You see, young children get married, doesn't mean they live together. But the girl will serve the boy, but it doesn't mean that they're, you know, that they're sleeping together and like that.
是的，就是那恢复这个早婚。
Go to money. Guru Mani? Guru Mani?
Shada, Guru.
No.
Guru Mani, Jisho.
Okay.
Hare Krishna. Sorry, my computer suddenly shut off. 刚才的问题是这样的，就是早婚，是得根据一个国家的情况，有的国家是不允许这样做的，因为他们不理解伟达传统。然后呢，就是早婚是这样的，就是姑娘和男孩子他们是不住在一起的，是。女孩子结了婚之后就服侍伺候这个男孩子，他们不会睡在一起睡觉。Hare Krishna.
Yes, Hare Krishna. So, we do see in ISKCON there are families like that where the family, the mother and father in ISKCON and they brought up their children in ISKCON, they may arrange the marriage of their children earlier than usual.
In ISKCON, there are families, for example, their parents are volunteers. They will arrange their children at this age. They will get married and get married. There are such
situations. Yeah. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was his first marriage, you know, he was married when he was like 12 years old and his wife was 5 years old.
那么伟大的 Bhaktivinoda Thakur, 他结婚的时候呢他是12岁，他的妻子呢新婚的妻子才5岁。
So that was the custom at the time.
这个就是是这样的习俗风俗。
Of course, we're not saying that you should get married so young, but we do see, like, you know, young girls, you know, the younger girls, that their marriages are arranged.
嗯，we don't see that.
We don't see people getting married so young, like 5-year-old girl. We don't see that in ISKCON. But younger girls in their age, you know, in their teens, they get married young. They're married.
我们在 ISKCON 当中呢，从来没发现就是哪个女孩子5岁的时候就结婚了。但是我们看到了呢 ，ISKCON 当中也有的姑娘10几岁结婚的。Krishna Kumari, 你能帮我读问题的？我的问题没有了。
好的，稍等。Krishna Nama, 这个问题完事了是吗？
对。
Pancha Tadavapagu, 这是感谢鼓舞我的仁慈。Hare Krishna, 这个是
手机名，请问 Guru 所有奉献者，请问 Guru Deva， 如果听到不符合自己的话题或者话语心里就不高兴就难过，这时是不是处在假我当中？感谢 Guru 的解答。
This devotee is asking that if we heard something that we are not pleased, and if we it's not continue with us, and we feel very sorry, is it our false ego?
Well, it may be. We have to consider what is the subject matter. You have to consider, and is it something which is promoted, which is encouraged according to scriptures? We don't want to promote things which are not supported by the teachings of Shastra.
We don't want to promote things which are not supported by the teachings of Shastra.
Of course, we do have our own emotions, our own feelings, and we personal opinions, and on all of these different matters, and we have to understand that we are conditioned souls. So the environment which we grow up in affects us, and we become conditioned to think in particular ways.
当然了，我们都有个人的情感，我们有个人的观点。我们是受条件限制灵魂，我们生长的环境就不一样，所以我们的思维方式是不一样的。
We always have to battle against our own conditioning because of values and judgments which we've acquired through our upbringing.We bring them with us, we carry them with us, and we're reluctant to let go of them and to accept another way of thinking.
We always fight with our conditions. We have our own value system, we have our own opinion. As we grow up,我们都一直带着这些价值观，我们的观点，而且我们还不愿意放弃，不愿意接受新思想。
嗯 ，OK。
下一个是 Pushpa Sara， Hare Krishna， Nimai Gurudev， 请问 Maya 也是奉献者，如果我们取悦了他，就不影响我们的灵性修习了吗？那么怎么理解取悦奉献者就取悦 Krishna 呢？Prabhupada Devadas said that Maya is also devotee. If we please the Maya, then Maya will not influence our spiritual practice, will not have effect on our spiritual practice. So how to understand to please devotee that will please Krishna?
To please devotees will please Krishna?
Yes, Krishna will be pleased if a devotee is pleased.
Yes, Krishna will be pleased if the devotee is pleased because Krishna's in the hearts of all the devotees. All the devotees are very, very dear to Lord Krishna.
是的 ,Krishna 就在奉献者心中。所有的奉献者都是 Krishna 至亲至爱的。
Krishna says, Krishna says, I am in the hearts of my devotees, and my devotees are in my heart.
Krishna, 我在我的奉献者内心，我的奉献者也在我的内心。
Of course, you may say, well, Krishna's in everybody's heart. Yeah, that's true, but in everyone's heart, he's the super soul and he's passive. But in the devotee's heart, Lord Krishna is personally there.
你也可以说，那不是 Krishna 也在每个生物心中吗？确实， Krishna 超灵的形象在每个生物心中，但是那种状态是被动的状态。但是 Krishna 在他的奉献是亲自在他的奉献者心中。
嗯。
我们 she asked that if Maya is devotee, if we please the Maya, then Maya will not have influence on our spiritual practice.
Well, you have to understand how to please Maya. Maya is a devotee, so you want to please Maya, it's the same as pleasing Krishna. Maya is pleased when you please Krishna.
那你得知道怎么取悦 Maya, 因为 Maya 是奉献者。如果你取悦了 Krishna, 就取悦 Maya 了。Next one?
Yes.
Yogita Sharma, how Krishna Gurudev is a son on the basis of Lord Krishna Prabhupada, Yogi Gurudev Gauranga, since all feeling we have are from the Lord, can the feeling of being the master also from the Lord? 这个问题是 Yogita Sharma, 他问了几个问题。既然所有的情感来源于主，是不是做主人的这种情感也来源于主呢？
Well, yes, Krishna gives you that free will. You want to think you're the master, he'll allow you to play that, to be in that illusion.
是的， Krishna 给了您自由意志，如果你想当主人的话， Krishna 允许你处在幻想当中。
We have to understand Krishna facilitates our illusion. We want to be an illusion. I'm the master. I'm the controller. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, go ahead. And Krishna knows you're going to have problems.
Krishna, 他明白我的确，他也给我们提供这些便利条件。如果我们想做主人的话， Krishna 说那好吧，你就去当主人吧。但是 Krishna 知道他会有问题的。
What are we the master of? We're trying to be the master, yes, we're trying to be the master, but we're never successful.
我们努力当主人，但是我们永远不成功。
So Krishna facilitates, he allows us to forget how much struggle there is in trying to be the master. So he allows it, yeah, go ahead.Try and be the master. And I may think, I'm the master, I'm the controller, I'm supreme.
那我们 Krishna, 我们想当主人，然后 Krishna 就会帮助我们，允许我们忘记 Krishna, 忘记我们要做主人会有多么的挣扎，允许我们去做主人，允许我们去做控制者，允许我们去做至尊。
Okay.
The Lord always wants to be happy. Can people so we also have that quality of making myself happy? How do we answer when people ask such questions?
How do we make ourselves how do we make ourselves happy? What's it?
Can people see we also have the quality of making ourselves happy.
Well, we try to make ourselves happy, but how long are we happy for?
我们努力，这个问题是，这个问题是，他接着问第二个问题是说，我们想让自己变得快乐。那当人们问这个问题的时候，怎么回答？回答是。我们是努力让自己试图快乐，但是我们能够这么做多久呢？
Our happiness is very short, very flickering.
我们的快乐是非常短暂一世的，瞬间转瞬即逝。
But if we take shelter of Krishna, we can experience eternal happiness.
我们脱离 Krishna 就能够体验到永恒快乐。
Okay.
Supina Sangha Dasi Hare Krishna 将 Guru Braja 居民是 Krishna 奉献者，他们这一世来到 Braja 是负有使命做 Krishna 的朋友来的吗？所有 Krishna 的朋友是从物质界还是从灵世界来的呢？智生结束之后，所有同游都会回到灵世界吗？ There are three questions. So the Braja, the Brajavasi, they are devotees of Krishna. So in these lifetimes, they come to Braja. Are they all have their mission to be associates of Krishna?
Yes.
是的。他们是有使命做同游。
Yes.
All the associates.
Go ahead.
All the associates of Krishna, they come from material world or spiritual world. So after this, after they finish this lifetime, can all devotees return to spiritual world?
Well, there's different kinds of devotees who come to Braja. Some of the devotees who come, some of them come from the spiritual world to take part in Krishna's pastimes.
有来到 Braja 的有不同种类的奉献者，有的是从灵性世界下来的，是来参加 Krishna 消时光来的。
And when Krishna appeared, we're talking about when Krishna appeared there 5,000 years ago.Krishna came, and he came with some of his great devotees from the spiritual world.
当主 Krishna 五千年前显现在地球的时候，他是带着一些伟大的奉献者一起来的。
And then some also were great sages. They had seen Lord Ramachandra, and then when they saw Lord Ramachandra, they desired to have a relationship, an amorous relationship with him.But Lord Ramachandra told them, he said, I cannot do it and I cannot allow in this incarnation, but you come in my next incarnation when I'm Lord Krishna and you take birth in the families of the cowherd people. And at that time you can be gopis and we will have amorous relationship.
另外一个类型的奉献者是在主 Ramachandra 时代有一些伟大的圣人们。他们当时心中呢就升起了想跟主 Ramachandra 建立这种爱恋关系的想法，但是主 Ramachandra 对他们说，在我这一世的化身当中，你们不能跟我有这种关系，等我下一个，下一个化身就是主 Krishna 那一世的时候，你们可以投生在牧牛郎之家，投生为勾比牧牛姑娘，可以跟 Krishna 有一这种。
And then we have another group of gopis, they are the personified Vedas. The personified Vedas, they also want to take part in Krishna's pastimes. And so they also came and they took birth in the families of gopis.
第三类型的呢，是那些伟达经的化身，他们也想参加 Krishna 的消失光，所以他们也投生为勾比牧牛姑娘。
And they all went back to Godhead after Krishna finished his pastimes. They all went back to Godhead.
当 Krishna 结束他的逍遥时光之后呢，他们所有的都回到了灵性世界了。
Okay.
Next one.
Yeah.
Next one. 下一个。
Yeah.
下一个是来自于书籍，昨天 Divine Guru 的 Final One Guru 昨天遇到有人用几个老乌龟索要钱，让买乌龟的，如果给他一只乌龟100元，他就卖；少于100元一只，他就不愿意卖。昨天我可怜乌龟买了一只放生了，后来也想把剩下的放生，但他给我要将近500元，我没有忍心给他。却感到乌龟可怜，我给乌龟念了圣母， 我没有高价买下所有会放生，做得对吗？ This little piece called books obeisances to Guru. Yesterday, there is someone who sold pottery.
Sold one pottery.
Tortoise.
Ugui. Okay.
Yeah, this seller, this seller especially sold the tortoise to those people who would buy them to put them into the sea or the river. But the seller charged 100 yuan for each one. He would not sell less for 100 yuan. So I bought one and put it into the river or the lake. I want to buy all, but he charged me nearly 500 yuan. I didn't give her the seller, but I felt very pity for those tortoises. I chant the holy name for the tortoises, and I don't bought all the tortoises. Am I correct?
Well, it's not devotional service. You gave 100 yuan to that man. What's he going to do with the 100 yuan? Is he going to buy meat? Is he going to use it for sinful activities? You should be careful about who you give your money to. So, anyway, you put the tortoise back in the sea, but the man may go again, he may collect the tortoises again, come back tomorrow to sell the same tortoise. So, I mean, you didn't do any harm, but you didn't do any good either. Did you give the tortoise a holy name? Did you give it any prasadam?
Yes. She chanted the holy name for the rest of the tortoise.
Did she give it any prasadam?
你有没有给乌龟喂 prasadam 呢？
Anyway, okay. This is material activity. This is not devotional service.
这是物质活动的范畴，这不属于奉献服务的范畴。
You would be better to use your 100 yuan to buy some books and give them to people.
你不如把这一百块钱买一些书回来，然后派给。
Today is an auspicious day. It is called, not only is it the moon festival, but today is also called Bhadra Purnima. And in Srimad Bhagavatam, in the 12th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, it said if you give a set of Srimad Bhagavatams to people on this day, you get liberation.
So, today's this auspicious day, not only is it the Chinese New Year, it is also called Bhadra
Purnima.
他在圣典伯伽晚班，圣典伯伽晚第二篇说，如果谁在这一天买，就是把一套圣典伯伽晚班送给人们，他就得到解脱了。
So maybe you can't give them a whole set of Bhagavatam. You can give them one volume of Bhagavatam.
所以也许你可以送给人们一套圣典伯伽晚盘，或者一本。
如果你没有一头，你可以给他们一本。
啊，如果你没那么多钱，你给他们一本，不要他。
OK， 还有问题吗？
Additional Subhita Sangha said， 过去学佛的时候做很多放生，现在修 Krishna 之前，那些善恶业报都会消除吗？答不。Previously， when we practice Buddhism， we have done many activity like this to set free to those animals， but now we have practiced Krishna consciousness， can we eradicate all those bad karma， good karma？
Yes。By devotional service, you get free of all karma.
是的，通过做奉献服务，你就可以摆脱所有的善恶业报。
Yes, that's good. 还有问题？
没有了。
OK， 今天结束了。我们感谢 Guru Mani 给我们整台的翻译，感谢所有的奉献的聆听，祝福你们。春节快乐，万事如意，传教顺利。Hare Krishna， 舍利普鲁巴。
Hare Krishna， Hare Krishna， Gurudev。
Yeah。
那个 ，Yeah， 观察你们大姐，您看到Sukhita Sangha上面有一个问题回答了吗？看到没有？
回答了，回答了，回答。
那个
布拉这个居民，对，回答过了。
哦，好的，好的 ，OK， Thank you。
OK， 我们感谢Krishna Kumari Jujur， 感谢 Sati Jujur， 感谢所有的奉献和聆听提问，祝福你们春节快乐，不能吃太多，不能吃月饼太多，多念 Hare Krishna， 今天也是吉时，今天是 Bhadra Purnima， Bhadra 的满月，所以如果你可以送给人家一本书也很好， Hare Krishna。Srila Prabhupada ki. Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki.